Hello everyone, welcome to day 23rd of January Read Code Challenge, and today's question is sorts the matrix diagonally. The question itself explains, the title of the question itself explains the question. You are given a matrix and you need to sort it diagonally such that all the elements across a particular diagonal are sorted in nature. Let's walk through the example. The example says you have this matrix 3, 3, 1, 1, 2, 2, 1, 2, 1, 1, 2, and you need to sort them in a diagonal fashion. In this manner, across the diagonals, these elements should be sorted. This likewise, and the result is something like this. A sorting of this gives us 1 here, 1 remains same, then 1, 2, then 1, 2, 3, then 1, 2, 3 again, then 1, 2, and 1. How are we going to solve this question? So the first step is identify all the elements that are there in the diagonal and sort them. So there are two steps involved. One is identify to which diagonal it belongs to, the current element to which diagonal it belongs to, and once you have all those elements, sort them up and put them back into the matrix. How are we going to solve this question? We need to need some hint. What would be the identifier? If I am at a particular index in the matrix, what is my corresponding diagonal ID? The question itself gives you a hint. The hint says that all the cells in the same diagonal, ij, have the same difference, so that you can get to the diagonal of a cell using the difference. So the identifier that this cell belongs to a particular diagonal is I minus j. So let's walk through the presentation that I have created. And let me just start the slideshow. So we got the hint from the question that I minus j is the identifier. If you are not okay using the hint, some thought would have given you this by yourself. If you are well versed with the matrix problems, this is easy to deduce. So so all the elements of a particular color belongs to the same diagonal, and once you enter all of them in your data set, sort them up, put them back. So what I'll use map of my identifier would be I minus j as my key, because all the elements belonging to a particular diagonal is identified by I minus j key, and I can store it in a list, I can store it in a priority queue, I can use tree set as well. Anything of your choice would work that can help us get elements in a sorted fashion. So the first choice is a list, the second choice is a priority queue, the third choice is a tree set or a tree map. Tree set we can't use because duplication would be tricky. Then how will we handle duplicate kids? Then we have to take tree map, and list I'm not using because I have to explicitly call arrays dot sort on that list. I'll be going with the priority queue approach. And let me just confirm whether the hint that was given in the question, I minus j, is true or not. So let's walk through any diagonal. So let's walk through this diagonal. So I is 1, j is 0. So 1 minus 0 is 1. So the identifier becomes 1. And let's move on to when we get this element. So it's 2 minus 1 again. So 7 gets added, then gets 16. And 3 minus 2 is 1 again. 3 minus 2 for this element is 1 again. And we have 9. So as you iterate through all the complete matrix and use j minus ai as your map identifier, as your diagonal identifier, and you put elements across that identifier. And once you sort those elements, we are using priority queue, and hence we don't need to sort those elements. They're already sorted because we'll be using min priority queue or min heap. And you pull out element, once you have iterated through the complete matrix, you pull out elements from the map and dump it back into your updated matrix. Let's quickly code this up. You can write this code in few lines. It's not a tough question. It looks slightly tricky, but it's not tough. I'm calculating n and m, the coordinates of the matrix, the number of rows and number of columns, and I'm defining a map where the first part is the integer, and what we'll use integers key as I minus j, and the value would be a priority q of type integer again, and let's call this map new hash map. And let's iterate through the matrix and dump data into this map. I equals to 0, I is less than m, I plus plus for integer j equals to 0, j is less than n, j plus plus. And what is the identifier of our map? So let me just call it diagonal key. Diagonal key is I minus j. Map dot get or default diagonal key new priority queue. So I'm creating a new priority queue if it does not exist, of type integer pq, and I'll put in pq.offer the current element mat of I comma j, and put this priority queue back in the map. What is the key? The key is again the diagonal key, and what I'll put, pq. I'm putting pq back, and it will be automatically sorted if whenever I pull element from the priority queue. So writing the same logic again, the two for loops, and let's set the value from the priority queue. So it will obviously be there, so I don't need to use default here. I'll get the priority queue corresponding to the current diagonal, and I'll set it there in the matrix mat of I comma j equals to pq dot poll. Simple. So what have we done? We first of all, we added all the elements in the map against a particular priority queue, and you pulled out elements from that one because it will be automatically sorted because it's a min heap. You pull out elements from the priority queue corresponding to a diagonal key and set it in the matrix, back in the matrix. So it's like you are developing a data structure that is already, that is sorting, doing sorting by itself, and you are pulling out values from it after, once the sorting is done, once the value has been set. So return matrix. Looks good. And let me just submit this. Accepted. What's the time complexity of this? The time complexity is slightly the tricky part of this question. So what are the number of elements that you are handling, you're dealing with? It is m cross n. So tc is order of m into n because these are the number of elements that you're handling. And what are the number of elements that you're sorting? So that would be equal to log of the elements that are there in your diagonal. So number of elements in your diagonal, and what would be that? So n and m are clear to you, and d stands for maximum of or the minimum part. Let's think. Diagonal, yeah. So the number of elements would be the minimum of, so this is 3, 4, and at max the diagonal will have 3 elements. So the minimum of m comma n sounds good. And space complexity is obviously m cross n because you are adding m cross n elements in your map at max. Hope you enjoyed it. See you until next time tomorrow.